Philippine presidential bets continue their campaign 70 days before the elections. Senator Panfilo Lacson visited fisherfolk in Lucena and Quezon Province with his running mate, Senator Vicente Soto III. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno de Mogoso gets the backing of three labor groups, the Bus Transport Workers Alliance, the Alliance of Genuine Labor Organizations, and the National Confederation of Labor. Senator Manny Pacquiao, meanwhile, made the rounds in Metro Manila. He met with local officials of Pasig and Marikina.
Presidential bet Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. wants to discuss with the Elections Commission and other candidates the upcoming presidential debate sponsored by the poll body. Marcos's campaign manager, Benhur Abalos, reveals the former senator ordered him to ask the COMELEC and other presidential bets to first tackle the format of next month's debate. Abalos says the poll body has yet to respond to their camp's request, which they issued on February 11th.
Kasi ito ginagawa sa ibang bansa, particular sa Amerika, na lahat ng tatakbo roon sa debate ay talaga nag-uusap-usap para pagdating sa debate, yung ground rules ay settled na. Unfortunately, hanggang ngayon, wala pa hong sagot sa amin ang COMELEC. Wala pa. And that's on record. Look at the date, which is February 11. Siyempre, gagawa rin naman kami ng schedule namin. Kasi every day is very important for us.
The COMELEC earlier said all 10 presidential candidates would attend a debate. But Marcos's camp clarified they have to decide whether he would join the event. Marcos skipped Sunday's debate hosted by CNN Philippines.
And just like how it was during CNN Philippines' vice presidential debate, a political analyst believes it was also the incumbent officials who stood out during the turn of the presidential bets.
There are four strategic questions for the future of this country. How do we fully exit the pandemic? How do we rebuild the economy? How do we reform our governance institution? And how do we prepare for future shocks? Now, and obviously, those who had prior experience, as Professor Edna mentioned, like Vice President Lenny and Mayor Isko and Senator Ping, had the edge, no? Because they had proof of concept, no? They already did and address most, if not all, of these questions.
Professor Tehangki adds Senator Manny Pacquiao was the most improved candidate in terms of answering questions. Leody de Guzman, meanwhile, stuck to his guns as a labor leader. But Professor Edna Ko of the University of the Philippines says he needs to expand his platform of governance.
The socialist view of another candidate would be good in a battle of ideas, but at the end of the day, governance is a different thing from the theoretical frame of politics. It's about what will work under conditions of pandemic, under conditions of our economy, and the medium term forward on corruption, on taxation, and how do we mobilize beyond this a worker sector. How do we mobilize everyone to pitch in?
Vice presidential candidate Walden Belio wants to see a different format of future election debates. He says candidates should be more open to engaging one another directly. He adds longer time limits on interpolations would also be welcome so candidates can better communicate their standard issues and their platforms.
It might be good to give more time to the rebuttal, counter-rebuttal, because, again, that is the real test. People are more willing to engage in confrontative debates because of the fact that this uncovers not only issues, but what you are. My role here was to really bring this kind of critical, engaged discussion to the people so that they can learn and they can understand their own problems directly. And I think this is a sickness of our politics, that of our politicians, that they're scared of challenging one another directly.
Election watchdog Contradaya agrees on the need for longer time for rebuttals during debates.
I am hoping that perhaps ABS-CBN or any other news media organization would facilitate rebuttals and interpolations because these are integral to debates. I understand, Karen, that under the COMELEC guidelines, the COMELEC seems to discourage interpolation. So I hope that news media organizations would step up, because we can always invoke editorial independence with regard to the format.